गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, साई राम, वेलकम बैक टू योर ऑनलाइन कंप्यूटर क्लास। होप यू ऑल आर वेल एंड सेफ एट योर होम। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट चैप्टर 7 स्टार्टिंग वर्ड पैड। द वर्ड पैड इज अ टेक्स्ट एडिटिंग प्रोग्राम। इट इज यूज टू क्रिएट एंड एडिट द डॉक्यूमेंट्स। अनलाइक नोट पैड, वर्ड पैड, द डॉक्यूमेंट्स इंक्लूड रिच फॉर्मेटिंग एंड ग्राफिक्स। The formatting options like highlighting the text, bullets, line breaks, inserting pictures make the WordPad a powerful tool. For this, it has the following features. You can type any text like letters, notice, and save the data for future use. Beautifying the text using the different colors, text resize, letter styles and effects, insert the pictures, and you can take the multiple printouts. You can cut and paste the text from one place to another place. You can modify the text while typing or after typing the whole text. For this, first of all, how can you open the WordPad? For this, you have to click on the start button, then click on the all programs, then click on the accessories, and then click on the word page. Next is components of WordPad screen. First is title bar. It is the horizontal bar at the top of the window. It contains the title of the application and name of the documents. The title bar also contains the control button, that is minimize, maximize and close button at its right side. Next is minimize buttons. The button with a small horizontal line is called the minimize button. If you click the minimize button, it will reduce the window to a button on the taskbar to bring the window back to the original size. Then click the same button on the taskbar. Minimize button. This button has one square on it. Then click the maximize button to enlarge the window to its possible maximum size. Next is restore button. When you maximize a window, the maximize button is replaced by the restore button. The button with two square is located at the right side of the bar on the maximize window. Next is close button. The button with a cross symbol is called the close button. To close the WordPad application, you have to click on it. Next is quick access toolbar. It contains the button to do the common task. By default, new, open, save, undo, redo command appear on this bar. We can also add the commands to it as per our need. Next is WordPad button. It contains different options to the work in WordPad. Next is ribbon. The ribbon consists of three parts: tabs, groups, and commands. Tab. Each tab contains tools arranged in different groups, and a group is a set of related commands. Next is scroll bar. Allows you to view the contents of a window when there are too many items to be viewed at one time on the screen. Next is the document area. This is the main working area where you type and edit the text. Here you can see these all options: tab, group, quick access toolbar, document area and the ribbon also. Next is creating a new document. To create a new document, first of all, you have to click on the WordPad button and select the new option. A new document will open. Then type the text about your required topic. Here you can see the topic on friendship. Next is saving a document. After finishing the work in WordPad, it is necessary to save it. Till you do not save the documents, the complete data remains in the computer's temporary memory. But if power goes off or someone switches off the computer, all the data stores in memory will be lost permanently. To prevent the data loss, you must have your file to save. For saving, you have to follow some steps. First of all, you have to quick access toolbar and click on save or press the Control plus S button. Then click on the WordPad button and select the save option. You will get the save as dialog box where you can type the file name and then click on the save button. After that, you will get that your file has been saved and the name which you have given appear on the title bar. Now children, you have to read this chapter again in your book. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you. Sairam.